Let's move on to our panelists, Vinod, and if I can start with Mr. Ghulam Nabi Azad. Good evening.
Good evening.
And welcome to the show. You just heard Sanjay Singh saying they had spent 35,000 rupees. You have accused VP Singh of spending 1.6 crores. How much have you spent?
Well, I have not sent only 1.6 crores. I have said 1.61
crores.
61 crores.
Okay. So you don't agree with 35,000?
No, not at all.
Okay.
And it's most unfortunate, a person saying like this, he wanted to fight the corruption at the high level and he wants to fight the corruption with money, money power. A party which is still in infancy, which is still yet to burn. And he's the person who has himself said on a number of occasions that this is not a party at all. It is just individual. One individual can spend 1.61 lakhs. I think this is very amazing.
But how does that compare with your expenditure? That was the second part of my question.
Well, as far as the Congress party is concerned, this is a 104-year-old party and we have been ruling both in states and center for the past 40 years. We can claim that our party people are in a position to spend money on their own, from their own pocket. But on the other side, a person who is who doesn't have the party, who doesn't have the party workers, how can he spend so much of money?
How does this imply that a party which is 104 years old and has been in power for 40 years, therefore it will have more money,
the members will have more money? No, this is the involvement of more workers and more participants, because it is a big paraphernalia. So there is no need of spending the money because everybody is capable of spending money from his own pocket.
Because they've been in power for 40 years.
No, because it's not only because of being in power for 40 years, but it's the question of the workers' participation.
Not that they have made the money.
Not they have made, it's more participation. But on the other side, he doesn't have the workers with him. Whatever work he's getting done, it is after paying the money. That's the difference.
Now, I'm surprised how Mr. Ghulam Nabi Azad came up with that figure to begin with. Second thing is saying that Jan Morcha, or the opposition candidate, he's a joint opposition candidate, doesn't have any workers. If you look at it, I went there, I spent some time. There are workers from all over the country coming on their own, spending from their pocket. So I don't know how you can say that Congress is 104 years old. And you specifically said they have been in power, so they can spend more money. There I'll agree. That's exactly the reason they are spending more money. They have been in power. They have been misusing that power to collect money and trying to win elections by money power. Now, when the question comes up that VP Singh also spent so much money or put up posters and all that. See, the point of VP Singh's campaign is that money power should not be used to win elections. He's not saying that you don't put up any posters or anything at all.
He said it.
But no posters at all. But the spirit of his announcement, the whole fight has been that Congress has been winning on money power, on the government patronage.
Well,
in fact, there's hardly any distinction between the government and the Congress party campaign.
One small point, if I might interrupt.
Yes. Yes.
How about these motorcycles? You know, there was a great fleet of motorcycles.
Yes.
They were all individually owned.
Yes.
They were.
Yes, of course.
No, I must. No. I must differ.
You don't
here.
Think? I don't think you can hire a lot of motorcycles.
I must differ
anyway.
Here. Almost.
And even if you do, it costs much more, less than hiring a car.
I must differ here with Ajit ji. Out of the 3,000 motorcycles, 2,500 were brought from Haryana by Devi Lal ji, and I saw myself with my own eyes unloading the motorcycles from the Haryana trucks.
What you are saying is that before Mr. Devi Lal said there were no motorcycles.
Well, even yesterday, I saw myself, Devi Lal ji, with 300 motorcycle riders dropping them from one polling booth to another polling booth.
300 riders, 300 motorcycles.
I think before we get into the figures and number of motorcycles, etc., I'd just like to ask you about, since Chaudhary Devi Lal's name has been raised, he has said that VP Singh will be the leader of the opposition. Do you subscribe to that?
See, my view and most of the opposition leaders subscribe to this view is we need to come on a platform and fight on certain issues. The question of who the leader would be, we'll leave it to the, you know, when we are all together fighting on issues, someone will emerge, or in a democracy, it's the right of the elected members to elect their leader. I think it's a little premature to raise that issue.
But would you, no, it's a simple question of yes or no. Would you support VP Singh as your leader?
What I'm saying is I support that all opposition parties get together on a platform and fight the Congress on issues. It's immaterial who the leader is.
You haven't replied a question.
Actually, I'm just asking a simple question and a simple answer. No, yes or no?
I don't think I'm on a witness stand so that I answer yes or no. Okay, I made my position very clear.
Okay, one inference which I want to draw. You said that VP Singh said that election should not be won on Manipur.
Yes.
My inference is that he says election should not be won on Manipur, but he doesn't mind spending money.
No, no, what he's saying is the money power that Congress is able to throw in these elections distorts the will of the people. Money has to be spent in elections, propaganda has to be done. You have to get your views across to the voter. But the amount of money that Congress, by virtue of being in power for last 40 years, is able to throw in election distorts the electorate's view.
Can I just ask Nihal Singh to join in, because
And one more thing before I say that, even in USA, the opposition candidate is given government money to fight the election. So we should make some arrangement like that here.
Well, can I interrupt here? Well, I think this is, one should understand that my friend Ajitji still has a doubt in his mind that his party is not going to accept him as the leader. So it is a just opportunistic alliance which has made them to contest the Allahabad election. Otherwise, there is no conviction between all these political parties. They are right from left to the right center, and there is no this whole alliance between these political parties is based on how to defeat the Congress without being any basic principles, without being any having any ideology, and any election and any alliance which is not based on principles and programs, I don't think that's going to last
but
long.
But one thing that these elections have shown, these by-elections, that when the opposition unites with one candidate, it tends to get the support of the electorate. Can I just switch to another topic and introduce
Mr. Robert, can I answer
I know it's very difficult for Mr. Nihal Singh to come in. But can I just ask you, Mr. Nihal Singh, that you have watched these campaign, the campaigning and the methods of campaigning, and I'm referring to various godheads being used in the campaigning. Do you see this as a change? Do you see it was started by NTR? What do you feel about this kind of method of campaigning?
Well, I think what has essentially happened is that what was restricted so far to the south of the Vindhyas has come north with a difference. Because in the south we've seen politicians who were either the great Robin Hoods or, say, N.T. Rama Rao, who has taken godly attributes, not only in what he says, but also in the dress. Now, of course, in the North, we didn't have such candidates.
Does it work?
So, well, apparently it does, at least in the South. But, you know, the trouble in the North was that there were no such candidates. So what they've done is they've gone to a soap opera on an epic, and taking characters from that and try to bring them in, and while hoping that some of that would rub off, which I think is a rather reprehensible thing.
I think at this stage we should ask Mr. Azad. Jab Congress ne faisla kiya ki Ramayan mein jo abhineta hain Arun Govil jo Ram ka abhinay karte hain unko Allahabad bheja jaye, to aapke zehen mein Allahabad ke voter ki kaisi tasveer thi, ki voter kaisa hota hai, kya wo aise झांसों में आ जाता है या ऐसी बातों से वो प्रेरित होकर वोट दे देगा कांग्रेस को? आपके जहन में सोच क्या थी उस वक्त?
नहीं, जब अरुण गोयल आया इलाहाबाद में, उन्होंने हर पब्लिक मीटिंग में यही बताया कि जब वो अभी बम्बई में ही थे और उनको तकरीबन 2 महीने से प्रयास कर रहे थे वीपी सिंह जी अपनी तरफ घुमाने के लिए, और कई दफ़ा उन्होंने उनके पास आदमी भेजे और ये लाने के लिए कि आप इलाहाबाद आओ मेरे लिए कंपेन करने के लिए, और जब उन्होंने कंपेन करने से इनकार कर दिया तो तब वीपी सिंह जी ने स्टेटमेंट दिया कि ये राम नहीं है बल्कि रावण है।
सवाल
इस चीज को मानकर वो वहां उनके खिलाफ प्रचार करने के लिए आए।
कांग्रेस ने क्यों मंजूर किया ये उनका प्रचार करना, या किसी सिने अभिनेता का या किसी अभिनेता का प्रचार में इस्तेमाल? कांग्रेस ने क्यों मंजूर?
वो तो एक सिटीजन है इस मुल्क का, मेरे ख्याल में उसको पूरा हक है, जैसे कोई भी सिटीजन का किसी और सिटीजन का हक है उतना ही उसका भी हक है।
चाहे अगर वो टीवी सीरियल में काम करता है, लेकिन वो हिंदुस्तान का एक नागरिक है, हिंदुस्तान का एक वोटर है, और हर हिंदुस्तान के एक नागरिक का, एक वोटर का हक है अगर वो फील करता है किसी पार्टी की मदद करना, मैं नहीं समझता इसमें।
लेकिन आपने इस तरह से इलाहाबाद के वोटर की धार्मिक भावनाओं को भड़काने की कोशिश की, क्योंकि गोविल साहब गोविल की तरह जाके उन्होंने वहाँ पे प्रचार नहीं किया, उन्होंने प्रचार किया रामायण में जो राम है उनकी तरह। तो सवाल ये है कि गोविल साहब जाके कर सकते थे प्रचार, लेकिन उनकी क्या मतलब, कांग्रेस ने तो उनको प्रेजेंट ऐसे किया कि वो रामायण के राम हैं और वो कांग्रेस के कैंडिडेट के लिए
प्रचार।
अगर अजीत सिंह जी कहीं जाएंगे तो वो कहेंगे कि जनता पार्टी के जो प्रेसिडेंट है वो आ रहेंगे, खाली अजीत सिंह बताएंगे तो आई डोंट थिंक एनीबॉडी विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हिच अजीत सिंह, हु वुड वी अंडरस्टैंड।
नो, कैन आई जस्ट से, कैन आई जस्ट आस्क यू, आर यू एज क्रिटिकल ऑफ एनटीआर्स यूज ऑफ द सेम मेथड्स?
जैसा कि निहाल सिंह जी ने कहा कि विंध्या में पहले हो रहा है इस तरह की चीजें, एमजीआर ने भी इसी तरह किया, प्रेम नजीर भी केरल में है, लेकिन जैसा उन्होंने कहा कि ये गलत बात है वहाँ भी, और जो नॉर्थ में आ रहा है ये और भी ज्यादा है, तो इस तरह का इस्तेमाल करना धार्मिक भावनाओं का गलत है।
मेरे ख्याल में वहाँ अपोजिशन कर रही थी तो इसलिए उस पर कोई ऑब्जेक्शन नहीं हो सकती, क्योंकि खाली कांग्रेस नहीं कर सकती, अपोजिशन जो चाहे उसे वो कर सकती।
नहीं, सवाल हम इलाहाबाद के इलेक्शन का, बाय इलेक्शन का कर रहे हैं।
आई वॉन्ट आस्क ए क्वेश्चन मिस्टर निहाल सिंह, दिस इज प्रोबेबली द लास्ट बाय इलेक्शन बिफोर द नेक्स्ट जनरल इलेक्शन, व्हाट डू यू थिंक इज द मैसेज गिवन बाय द इलेक्टोरेट अकॉर्डिंग टू द ट्रेंड्स अवेलेबल नाउ?
Well, the message is mixed, but I think one part of the message which is clear is that there is a lot of dissatisfaction with the Congress Party.
Okay, I'll do a brief recap.
Yes, please.
अगले आम चुनाव से पहले शायद ये आखिरी उपचुनाव थे, लेकिन भारत के नागरिक ने ना ही कांग्रेस आय को और ना ही विपक्ष को अपनी मंशा जाहिर की है या अपनी इच्छा जाहिर की है। उसने सीधा साधा ये संदेश दिया है कि अभी अगले आम चुनाव में 1.5 साल का वक्त है और वो दोनों को, पक्ष को और विपक्ष को जांचेगा परखेगा।
कैन आई जस्ट आस्क वन लास्ट राउंड अप क्वेश्चन, लिटरली वन सेंटेंस ईच, बेस्ड ऑन दीज बाय इलेक्शन रिजल्ट्स, वुड यू लाइक टू सी अ जनरल इलेक्शन हेल्ड टुमारो?
वी आर रेडी फॉर जनरल इलेक्शंस एनी टाइम।
एंड यू सर?
Well, these by-elections are not going to affect the popularity of the Congress Party, whatsoever it may be, maybe at the center level and the state level. But we have still 1.5 years to go. Why should we go for the elections?
Thank you.